How tall are you?
I'm 5'1".
What's your ideal height for a guy?
He has to be 6'1 and above.
6'1 and above?
Yes.
Why is that?
Welcome back or welcome to Uncle ABL. And in today's video, we're talking about the 6 foot or better height requirement that many women have for men in the good old US of A, maybe even in the Western world in general. Now, the reason why I say Western world is because in other parts of the world, this is not really a thing. In other cultures in America, that's not really a thing. Listen, where I live, we got a whole lot of Guatemalans, and everybody from the mama, the daddy, the grandmama, the grandpappy, the kids are no taller than 5'2". They are all short. I'm not seeing their women talking about, oh, it's going to be above 6 foot. That's not really a thing. You go to certain parts of Europe, Africa, Asia, the whole 6 foot requirement is not really a thing, but it is here in the USA. And I think that's for a variety of reasons. And it's not just dating. It's also other things. You're talking about most of your CEOs, your executives are above 6 foot tall. Most of our presidents of the USA have been above 6 foot. The last president who was not 6 foot tall was Jimmy Carter in the 1970s. And I think he might have been 5'10", 5'11". All of them beyond that, you're talking about Reagan, HW, Slick Willie, Trump, Obama, were all above 6 foot, maybe even 6'2", 6'3". Have you seen Trump's boy, Barron? This guy is about a good 6'8", looking like a whole European basketball player. It's crazy out here. The height obsession has really taken root in the West. Now, we're going to see a few clips. First, we're going to see some interviews at a baseball game where a guy who's very tall, obviously, is asking the question to women, what's your height requirement? Then we're going to see what some guys are doing to actually meet that standard. And we're also going to see a woman who does not have this crazy height requirement. And of course, I will pause it at certain points to give my 2 cents. But without further ado, let's go ahead and roll it.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'1".
What's your ideal height for a guy?
He has to be 6'1 and above.
6'1 and above?
Yes.
Why is that?
Because if he's 6 feet tall, he's probably lying. He's probably 5'10". He's got to be at least 6'1", so that means he's probably 6 feet.
But see, the question was why? Why has he got to be so tall? She's not really answering the question. She's just kind of saying, well, I came up with that number because if he is 6 foot on his dating app, he's probably shorter. But she's not saying why he has to be 6 foot. You understand?
It's girl math.
Girl math. Why do you think they lie about their height?
I feel like it's because they're insecure about it, but it's like, don't lie. Like, you know, like.
Would you rather be a liar or would you rather be short?
Well, they're both, so.
Yeah, you're tall. How tall are you?
I'm 6'9".
Oh, yeah.
How tall are you?
5 foot.
You're five foot even?
I say 5'5".
So what's your ideal height preference for a guy?
Boyfriend's 6'3", so.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, they love them. You know, they could be 5 foot tall. He got to be 6'1", 6'2", 6'3". That's what they like. That's very common.
Yeah.
So he's a solid, a little over a foot.
Doing the math here, carry the one. That is over a foot.
16 inches, however many, 16.
Yeah. Something like that.
Yeah.
How does it work for you guys?
It works.
Okay, I kind of understand what he was talking about there, but we keep on rocking and rolling. This is a family show.
Straight to the point. All right. How tall are you?
6 foot.
Exactly on the dot?
On the dot.
So what's your ideal height for a guy?
I've struggled with height for guys because it's so hard to find somebody above 6 foot. Mm-hmm. So I'm not too picky to a point. 6'1". He has to be taller than me.
6'1" or up?
Yeah.
How tall are you in heels?
Depends on what size the heels are.
Yeah, she's 6 foot with some heels on. She's going to be 6'3", 6'4", with a pair of heels. Like, she's going to be very tall with heels. And shout out to all the tall girls out there. You guys are amazing.
That's fair.
They're 4-inch heels. I'm 6'4".
That's good math.
All right, so that's what's happening. Now, you can see this is very common in the West, in the USA especially. Women, they love them a tall guy. Now, I'll get to my own anecdotal stories about that in a minute. But first, I'm going to show you this guy who has had surgery to go from being short to 6 foot, all right? You're going to see what some guys are going through. And it's not just him. There's a lot of guys doing this and a lot of guys inquiring into doing it.
This guy who goes by Mr. Broken Bones spent $80,000 to get taller with height extension surgery starting at a height of 5'5".
$80,000. And again, he was 5'5" from the beginning. $80,000.
He had two surgeries where doctors broke his bones in six places and implanted devices called fixators to stretch his legs. While he recovered for 6 months, he lived in a rehab facility and had to turn a handle on his fixators every day.
Ouch, that's gotta hurt.
After that, he spent almost a year regaining the muscle he lost so he could walk normally again. This is him standing next to his friend before the surgery, and here he is after gaining 7 inches, now at 6 feet tall.
That's a big difference. It really is, but you got to ask yourself, is it worth 6 months of living in a rehab facility? Is it worth spending $80,000? Is it worth having your bones broken and going through all that just to get taller?
What do you think? Would this be worth it? This guy.
Yeah, I'm not really sure. And look, I'm going to just tell you some, I'm going to just give you an anecdote right here, okay? I'm going to give you an anecdote, and I'm going to get to this screen where they have the comparison between his former self and the new self. Now, I am 6'3", and I've been tall for a long time. I was 6 foot at age 14 in high school, so ninth grade, freshman, I'm already 6 foot. Awkward, no confidence, real nerdy, but real tall. So I always got a lot of attention from people, especially the women. And I didn't even know it at that time how to really handle the attention. I didn't really know how to talk. I was just tall. Being tall in this country is a cheat code, 100%. Listen, you could be out of shape. You could be broke. But if you're tall and you stand out, that puts you above the rest. And a lot of times what guys do in this country is they find ways to compensate for not being tall or being short, because it's one thing to not be tall. You could be 5'9", 5'10". That's not really short for a guy, but it's not tall either. You're like average height. But if you're 5'7" and below, guys got to do things to stand out, whether it be having a bunch of money, flashing jewelry, cars, being in really good shape, having a really good talk game. You got to do something to stand out above the guys who are much taller than you. Guys like me, we don't really got to do a lot. But when guys like me have the money, success, the height, and we're in shape, it's like we're pretty much unstoppable. We are unstoppable. We are overwhelmed with women hitting us up with opportunities. And you are also seen as an authority figure. You're seen as an authority. Like I said, most of your executives in this country, above 6 foot. Presidents, above 6 foot. When I was in D.C., some years back, we went into the White House, not outside, but inside the White House for an event. And I had my suit and I'm clean shaven at the time. People were coming up to me, total strangers. Are you a politician? Do you work here? Because they automatically assumed by how I was dressed, me being in shape, no beard, gut, nothing like that. Clean shave, tall. They're going to think that I'm a politician because that's the politician look. Okay. Being in power is not just about your talents and your abilities and your intellectual capability, it's about your look as well, okay? When you're talking about becoming the president, I'm not trying to see some obese person, Chris Christie, become the president, nor am I trying to see a short person become president, Kamala Harris, Hillary Clinton. And they are also in the category of women, but I don't want to get into the male versus female thing when you're talking about authority figures, but I'll put it to you this way before I go to the next clip. Most women respect men as authority figures over women. Again, most women respect men as authority figures over women. That's real talk. But let's get to the next one here, because this might be kind of a feel good thing. And I'm willing to bet that she is not American, which kind of underlines my point. Check it out.
How old are you?
38.
How tall are you?
4'11".
How tall do you want your man to be?
I don't care. It's not about that. It's about the way you treat me and your kindness. Like, trust me, since I've been married for so long, I've seen the ugliness of people. Like, I just want somebody nice and respectful. And
now, do you think she's American? That's something I want to ask you guys. And also, she is married, so shout out to her. And shout out to the desirable truth for this clip.
Sweet and loving.
So you don't care if he was 5'2", you would give him a shot?
I would not care.
So when it comes on to a first date, what are you looking to get from that experience?
I would like to go out somewhere nice and treat it with respect and consideration.
Do you have a specific price range that a man should spend?
I mean, not really. Just as long as, like, your heart's there and you're coming from the right place. And there should be a certain chemistry. So I would only accept to go on a date with someone that I felt, like, somewhat interested in.
So this is somebody that has a head on straight, that is saying all the right things. And I'm willing to bet She sounds American in her accent, but I'm willing to bet she's either not American or first generation, and she saw that with her parents growing up. She was not really involved in a lot of the American culture that could be kind of ugly at times. Now, as I close, I want to say this. Shout out to everybody that's not tall. I understand your pain. Well, I can empathize with you guys. Maybe I can't say I understand. I've been tall for a long time. I've been tall since I've been a kid. Even before I was 6 foot at 14, I had a growth spurt when I was like, I think in the fourth or fifth grade. So it's a picture of me. If I could find it, I'll show you guys. But I'm with my cousins and I'm holding some toys I got for Christmas. I'm like 9 or 10 years old. Everybody's like a good 6 to 8 inches shorter than me. I was always really tall. So I understand what it's like to get a lot of attention, and it's kind of a cheat code. It's easy. So I see why guys wanted to get the surgery, but my advice to you guys is not to spend 80 grand, 100 grand and all of that on a surgery. Just get your money up and go about it that way. You know, your Jeff Bezos and Mark Zuckerberg, these are not real big, tall guys, but it doesn't matter because look at who they are. They're titans in industry. But that's pretty much all I got. Whatever your thoughts are, please let me know in the comments below. And that's all I got to say for this video. If you like what you heard, please comment, rate, share, and subscribe. Peace.